Hey guys, it's Chris. You know, I try to keep these videos really positive, but this week that's kind of tough. I'm filming this on Sunday, so we just found out last night about the Trayvon Martin George Zimmerman verdict. Between that and the laws limiting women's rights in Texas and other states, it's a pretty big come down from Prop 8 in DOMA. I don't have much to say about Trayvon Martin and George Zimmerman. Honestly, I'm just too angry and frustrated to really get into it. And I've done more than my share of arguing about who did what to who and when and where race comes into all of this, and I'm just tired of it. I will share that I do live in Harlem, and it's just crushing to walk down the sidewalk and see all these people who've been told yet again that their lives and the lives of their children matter less than some other person's fear. But like I said, I didn't come here today to talk about Trayvon Martin or George Zimmerman. I came here to talk about Orson Scott Card, because Orson Scott Card thinks he's entitled to tolerance. Orson Scott Card is a science fiction author who's fairly well known within the genre, but I don't think well known outside of it. He's written a number of successful books and series, and was a personal favorite of mine when I was younger. He not only influenced my writing, he's the first person who taught me anything about making a living as a writer. I bought his book, How to Write Science Fiction and Fantasy, through the Science Fiction Book Club when I was about 14 years old, and it's the only book I ever actually waited in line to have signed by the author. But Orson Scott Card is about to become a lot more famous. His novel Ender's Game, about young children engaged in futuristic space warfare, has been adapted into a Hollywood film that comes out later this year. And here's where it gets interesting. See, Orson Scott Card has also become something of a professional homophobe. He's been outspoken on a few occasions about his views on homosexuality, and particularly on laws prohibiting homosexual acts. About 20 years ago, he said that he felt it was important for homosexual acts to remain illegal so that people who might commit them would understand they couldn't still be functioning members of society. Orson Scott Card is also a Mormon, an active member of the Church of Latter-day Saints. And while I'm in no way anti-Mormon, and I'm a huge defender of religious freedom, it's important to realize the Mormon Church has spent an enormous amount of money in the last decade opposing LGBT rights. Prop 8 in California, for instance, probably never would have passed a vote if the Church of Latter-day Saints hadn't funded a campaign for its passage. More recently, he's sat on the board of the National Organization for Marriage, also known as NOM, which has nothing at all to do with lolcats. It's got a whole lot more to do with going state to state and spending a whole lot of money, mostly provided by the Mormon Church, to run dishonest campaigns opposing marriage equality and other rights affecting the LGBT community. So a number of people, including myself, have announced that we won't go see Ender's Game because we don't want to be putting money in Orson Scott Card's pockets. I'm not sure anyone's actually called for a full-on boycott, but I certainly wouldn't oppose it. Orson Scott Card was asked in an interview recently about that boycott, and basically said that since he feels the Supreme Court has answered the marriage equality question, he hopes that people will set aside his views and go see the movie. And then he has the nerve to speculate whether the people threatening to boycott his film will show him tolerance. By the way, I'll post a link to the actual interview in the description of this video so you can read his words directly. But let's talk about this tolerance thing for a minute. See, I've been hearing this a lot from people who say racist or homophobic things, or who campaign to limit the rights of other people. And I don't think they really understand how tolerance works. I mean, I'm the biggest advocate ever of free speech. You can go around and say whatever you'd like to say, no matter how horrible it is. Frankly, if you have horrible opinions, I'd rather you voice them loudly so everyone can know what a terrible person you are. But there's an enormous difference between having and voicing an opinion about what people should and shouldn't do, and actively campaigning for the government to deny someone's right to do something. I was a huge fan of Orson Scott Card, and I continued to read his stuff well through the 90s, even when I knew his anti-gay views. When I stopped was when I realized that by spending money on his product, I was funneling money into campaigns to deny the rights of myself and people I care about. At this point, we're not just talking book money, we're talking Hollywood money. Orson Scott Card is at a point in his career where he could become the next George R.R. Martin, meaning he could transform from somebody popular inside the genre to someone with mass appeal. And at that point, any number of his books might get TV and film adaptations. Now, anyone who knows how writers make money can tell you that one movie can mean more money in your pocket than all the books you've ever written combined. And remember that while the recent DOMA ruling does affect how the federal government treats marriage equality, there are still a ton of states where same-sex couples can't get married. One, for example, being Pennsylvania, where my former colleagues at the ACLU have just sued for marriage equality. Each of these states is going to have to go through a fight over marriage equality, and in every case, we can expect NOM and the Mormon Church to be there opposing it. And we can expect Uncle Orson's dollars to help fund it. So to Orson Scott Card, I say, I'm entirely tolerant of your views. What I'm intolerant of is your direct action to try to push the government to force your views on me and the people I care about. See, I'm not the one being intolerant here, and I'm not the one opposing free speech or free expression. That would be Orson Scott Card. Ender's Game, meanwhile, remains a terrific book, and I highly recommend that you read it. Get it from the library, borrow it from a friend, or read it some other way that it's not going to send money into Orson Scott Card's pocket. On a personal note, part of what really depresses me about all this is one of the great things about Ender's Game and its sequel, Speaker for the Dead, is how they teach about empathy for your enemy, or for those you perceive as your enemy. Which really seems to be a lesson Orson Scott Card has forgotten. Especially considering some of his later books, which amount to little more than anti-liberal propaganda. I mean, I'm talking like, liberals are going to be responsible for the fall of America kind of stuff. So if you're like me, and you're a geek who's also a supporter of LGBT rights, I say wait the few months for Ender's Game to show up on Netflix and HBO. Of course, I'm interested to hear your reaction and what you might have to say. If you think I'm looking at this the wrong way or I'm full of crap, feel free to say so in the comments below. Just do please try to keep it civil and well thought out. I'll be back next week, hopefully with something happier to talk about. So thanks for watching, thanks for thinking, and remember, don't just mourn, organize.